question.
Yep.
How is this different from Tetris?
So how is it different?
Yeah, what does the VR bring to that?
The VR, it's made by Luminosity. So like you have a one that's more vibrant. So when you're he's in a zone. Like they actually have a different portion where it puts you in a zone, and it changes the way that the actual form looks. So when he does the lines, you see they start flipping, they start changing positions. So instead of it just keeping that same static.
Flat.
That static when it actually flips the blocks around and changes the landscape, so you have to think on your feet.
Okay, and so he's not seeing that, he's seeing 3D.
He's seeing all the stuff behind him is all moving, but as far as like him catching anything extra, it's like you see the pieces moving, you have to find where the parts are going, because it all changes as the game goes. Like, when you're not in the zone, you don't have to worry about that, but the moment you get to the zone, you're thinking, oh, I'm getting rewarded, they're like, no, we're going to punish you. Like, we're going to punish you for being here. So, like, once you get to a line, you'll see it rotate. And you'll flip. See, like, what? She'll move it. She'll actually move certain parts out of the way the higher it goes. So, that's the thing that I think that's, like, very interesting. To me, at least, when I played it, I was like, oh, shit, I wouldn't expect that.
And just how you play, change the background and the music.
Yeah.
Yeah? That's the thing that's easier.
Yes, sir. That's another part. Yes, sir.
Yeah, like that's his thing.
Yes, sir. Yeah, that's another part too. It's like the way you play the different songs you go to, it changes the atmosphere, changes the background, also changes. Yeah.
I can't wait. I love this game.
Yeah, like it's just a staple. I mean, I was telling Joe before he sat down. I was like, my mother, Dr. Mario, Tetris.
And I think for VR, it takes a pure arcade game. There's a lot of nonsense about narrative,
exactly.
Storytelling.
It's just simple.
Just simple, like in the 70s.
Yeah.
One dot and a paddle, and you had Kong, and that was it. Revolution.
Yeah.
Where's the story? Oh, yeah. One day there was a little dot. It had a little argument with this little long line, and they hit each. No, none of that. You just play it.
Just play the game. Yeah.
Yeah. And I think that's what we need to teach developers.
Yep.
Pure arcade game theory.
Like there's definitely a void of like just good arcade games. Like a lot of indie developers are pushing it.
Yeah.
Like there's is similar to Tetris, it's called demo for like a year.
Yeah,
Hyper Cube. Super Hyper Cube.
Yeah.
Loved it. Because you can see in it, under it, look to the sides of it, put the pieces together. That was wonderful.
And the nice thing is these things will be like 500k of code. Genius. That's all you need. None of this like terabyte installs of, 1,000 terabyte of code. I won't say it.
Yeah.
Nice meeting you. What's your name?
Trevor.
I'm Navdeem.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Say hi to Yoshida-san.
Okay, cool. So, are we only going to see Yoshida-san?
Running around.
He's
shy.
He's